I have some files linked down below that have to do with FGDs that we're covering in this tutorial. So make sure and take a look just above the comments under Show More. I also have some links to Quoth and Arcane Dimensions, the mods that we're talking about today. So the next thing is a request from somebody in one of the comments of the Quick Start video. They wanted to know how to load up mods and work with mods. Now, I can't give you all the details of, you know, working with, let's say, Arcane Dimensions, because it's a huge mod. It's very powerful. It might as well be its own game. There's so much to it compared to making maps for Quake. So that's just a warning to you. If you want to skip making vanilla id1 maps and go right to Arcane Dimensions, good luck. I wish you well. So I always suggest for people starting out to just stick with vanilla, as we say, vanilla id1, which is the base game. From there, you can kind of graduate up to other mods, but Arcane Dimensions is a fantastic mod. I've made one map for it. Not my best map, but I got a feel for it by making that map, and I certainly will make more Arcane Dimensions maps. But let's go ahead and show you how to load up a mod into Trench Broom. So you'll need the mod installed into your Quake dev directory. I'm gonna go into AD, and I just wanna show you these files here. There's a .def file, and there's a couple of .fgd files. And those are entity definition files, and I'm gonna show you both of them. Before you load the entities though, let's do the other step first. We're gonna go to the map inspector and go to down to the bottom to mods. And you can see that the AD is right there listed. We're gonna hit the plus sign and you're gonna enable that mod. Then we'll go to entity, we'll load up the entity definition. So we have to navigate to it. So we'll hit browse. And as you can see, the Trench Broom version of the FGD shows up as the default. But I want to show you the def files first. So the def files, you drop this menu down and choose def. So we're going to open that up. What's going to happen is you're going to see the models now. If you load these up and these are all boxes and you can't see the models, you've forgotten to load the mod. I've done that a million times. So the thing is, go to the map tab, load the mod, enable it. Then your entities will show up. So you can do it out of order, but that's a common mistake. So now let's drag one of these new items. This is item backpack armor. It's unique to Arcane Dimensions. And we'll see that we have the information in here, you know, to change it to different colors and different setups and things like that. That's the strength of the .def files, is that you get these definitions and you have all this information at your fingertips. We're gonna change to the FGD file, the one that says TB. And you'll see we're getting all the 3D models again, but we don't have that detailed information. So for Arcane Dimensions, if you're first starting out, you're gonna wanna use that .def file. Luckily, Trench Broom, you can switch back and forth and use either one. It's just one of those things that the different editors have proprietary ways of dealing with it. And luckily for us, Trench Broom can use both FGD and .def. So that's Arcane Dimensions. And right now I've got Quoth loaded up. Quoth is a mod that's kind of similar to Arcane Dimensions in many ways. There's a tons of new monsters, as you can see some of them on the screen here. And the good thing about Quoth is that the FGD is built in already to Trench Broom. So you have to select it. It defaults when you go to entity definitions under the entity inspector. It's usually set to Quake. You see Quoth 2 down here. That's because it's for 2.0, I'm assuming. And you just select that and everything should show up. One other important thing that you want to take note of is where to save your map. And just remember to save it into the mods maps directory. So right here you see Quake Dev Quoth is the mod directory. And then I made a maps folder in that mod directory and I'm saving my maps there. And also the autosave, as you can see here, is saving there as well. So don't forget to do that because you might lose your map and go, wait, where is it? And I can't load it and all that stuff. Just make sure and save your maps into the mods maps directory. When you're working in Trench Broom, there's a very important distinction between .def files and .fgd. And like I said, you can switch back and forth between them, but this is very important to remember. If you use a .def file, you will not have the key value pairs automatically propagate up here in the entity inspector. So as you can see, I've got the Bog Lord highlighted, and he has all these different key values, angry target, exact skin, health, all that stuff. I'm going to unload this and load the .def file. And so you'll see the trade-off right away. Okay, for some reason, how funny. I thought the models would show up. I guess not all of them do. So that's one drawback there. The next one is you don't have any of the key value pairs at all. You have all this great information and explains what the key values are, and it tells you what they are, but it doesn't propagate them automatically into the editor. So you see the bounding box here, and that's fine. You can edit with this. This is the important thing to know, how big the monster is so that you can he can fit in your geometry. Obviously, it's nice to have the monster model. So unfortunately, you'll have to add these key value pairs, you know, manually. So I'll just type in health. That's one of them here. Health overriding the default health, so you could change the monster's health. And again, you have this great information here, but you don't have these key values. So what I would suggest is, if you're starting off with Arcane Dimensions, use the .def file, learn about all these key value pairs, and then just switch over to an FGD. Now, the reason these aren't showing up is that those two monsters I just put in are kind of newer monsters. So I don't want you to think that there's no models in the .def files. There are. There are definitely plenty of them. Just there are some, the ones I chose didn't happen to be in there. So that's just a quick overview of how to get mods working in Trench Broom. If you have questions, make sure and ask down in the comments below, and I'll try to get you the answer. You can also go to the Trench Broom Discord that's linked down below as well. There are a lot of helpful people there, including Maruto, who is very kindly working on the closed captioning for this series. I want to say thank you to him publicly. And go ahead and ask questions there. Come and meet us, talk to us, and we'll figure it out together. Thanks for hanging in there. We'll see you in the next tutorial.